Shalom lecholam. I'm Yaakov. In this episode, we'll look at the pre-Pesach or pre-Passover practice of removing leaven from our homes. The Torah says, for 7 days you are to eat matzot, unleavened bread. On the first day, you shall remove the leaven from your dwellings. Shemot or Exodus 12:15. Chameitz is the Hebrew word meaning yeast or leaven. On the evening prior to the first Pesach Seder meal, the head of the household makes the final preparation for Passover by leading the family throughout the home in a search for yeast. A candle is lit to reveal any hidden yeast, and a feather is used to sweep up even the smallest pieces of yeast into a wide spoon. This practice is called Bedikat Chameitz, or searching for leaven. On the morning following the search, all the leaven remaining in the house, such as loaves of bread and cakes made with yeast, is collected together along with the yeast found the night before and burned outside the house. In the scriptures, yeast is seen as a symbol of sin. As we prepare ourselves for the Passover Seder, we are reminded of our need for the light of the King Messiah Yeshua to shine on any areas in our lives where we have allowed sin to creep in, so that through Messiah we might continue to be sanctified, knowing that by accepting Him and His death and resurrection, we have already been perfected outside of time and space. Therefore, we see in the symbolism of Bedikat Chameitz a sweeping clean of the rooms of our being, both individually and corporately. The traditional Passover Haggadah, meaning the telling, reminds us that in every generation, each person is obligated to see himself or herself, lerot et atzmo, as though he or she personally came forth from Ha Mitzrayim, Egypt. The Hebrew Mitzrayim, Egypt, means double distress or compounded strife. Thus, we acknowledge that in Messiah we are set free from sin and the strife that compounds it. It is important to note that Yeshua instructed his Talmudim, or disciples, to obey the commandment regarding the preparing of the house where he would share in his last Pesach Seder prior to his death and resurrection. Habesorah al pi Lukos, the Gospel according to Luke, records the first century Jewish Passover preparations and includes the observance of Bedikat Chameitz in this way. Yeshua sent Kepha and Yohanan, saying, go and prepare unto us the Pesach, that we may eat. Habesorah al pi Lukos, or Luke 22:8. Throughout the Brit HaChadashah, or New Testament, we see Yeshua, who is both author and goal of the Torah, faithfully observing the Torah instruction of God. For Messiah is the goal of the Torah, in order to provide righteousness to everyone who believes. Therefore, as Messiah followers, we continue to practice these rhythms of God using physical symbols in order to glimpse the eternal unseen kingdom of God within the temporary symbolic elements of Torah practice. This reminds us of the fact that the kingdom of God is both now and yet future, and is firmly established in us through the redeeming work of the King Messiah Yeshua. We understand through this practice, Bedikat Chameitz, that in Yeshua we have been redeemed, past, present, and future, outside of time and space. We are perfect in Him. And within time and space, we continue to be sanctified, made holy, one room of our lives at a time. Because through one offering, Messiah has, past tense, made perfect for all time, future tense, those who are being sanctified, present and continuous tense. Hebrews 10:14. Bedikat Chameitz and the preparation for Pesach is a process of allowing God to prune our hearts. I wish you a Chag Pesach Sameach. Have a joy-filled Passover celebration.